You're like, okay, what is going on? And the reason why I wanted to do this was to be able to change your point of view on things, on me, on how I film, life, business, because I can talk all day long about the real estate bubble popping, car sales down, what, 10-year low, and how the government steals prosperity out of you now for future. Let me just explain. If they give you a car loan right now, you don't have to, what are the car loans now? You don't have to pay it back for 3 years or whatever. So you buy now. So sales go up now. But what's going to happen over the next 3 years is we don't have any more sales. And Americans are just sitting at home making more money at home than they would be actually going and getting a job and working, which I didn't believe until like everyone around me is like, yeah, I'm going to stay home for the next year. For those of you that know, I have 6 kids. Sometimes they pop on camera. That was my wife if she snuck in. 6 kids, and one of them I'm even going to talk about too in this video, how she's able to make money. She flies around the friendly skies, but she's going to make more money selling her knowledge than she will working. And then another daughter of mine, she's a bartender, and she's like, I make more money. I think it's $400 on unemployment, which, you know, they say, oh, it's 12 months, but you know how governments are. It's okay. We'll just give you another 12 based on the crisis. $400 plus $600, that's if I'm doing my math right, that's $1,000 a week. That's $4,000 a month. Why would you ever want to go back to work? And we're talking about the Fed. You can't really, you know, do much anymore without talking about the Fed. And Alan Meltzer, he's a professor from Carnegie Mellon. He did a book. I think it took him 15 years on the Fed. 15 years. So I'm going to summarize it for you. But those are just problems. I want to give you a mindset. I want to give you solutions. And then to answer the age-old question is, how much hairspray do I use? Wait, hold on. How much hairspray a day? Hold on. How much hairspray a day do I use on my hair? Welcome back to my channel. If you're new and you're like, who is this guy? What is going on? I'm just a dude. This channel is about you helping you start businesses with that money. We have to invest it. And that's what this channel is all about, changing the way you think, but also like what the heck is going on in the business world and how can we profit from it? And if that sounds interesting to you, would you at least just consider subscribing? You don't have to turn the bell notification on because that could probably get annoying. But you know what? Subscribing would be nice. That way when I say something and you're like, wanted to tell something, you're like, oh, there's some dude. He looks like Johnny Bravo. And wait, hold on. I forgot to subscribe. So in world news, looks like Kim Jong-un, not looking too good. We're going to have to see what kind of propaganda comes out of that side. But this picture just freaks me out. Right next door to me, I live in Southern California, and this is what we call the real economy. There's the real economy. If you want to know how we're doing, don't look at the news. Don't look at the stock market. Look at that. And I don't know, from my bird's eye, all I'm seeing is a lot of nice cars, man. And I bet, you know what? I wonder what people do with their stimulus money. Oh, let's go buy stuff rather than start businesses, rather than learning about passive income. Let's go buy a car because it'll make us feel better now, but now we'll just worry about the pain later. And what I'm trying to do is count how many Teslas can we find in here? How bad this car? I don't know. That looks like a sports car. Some of these cars look really nice. Do you not feel a little bad when your Falcon Wing doors, you're pulling up and you're like, yeah, just go ahead and put it in the trunk. And for those of you that know me, I am not a green guy. I just like green stuff. I also sell green stuff. But yesterday I lost my electricity and I don't know because I have these. I have solar. I got solar right there. It doesn't look as nice as that. That's like sexy solar. I have unsexy solar. I think I need to get a power wall because I did not have electricity. It was 91 degrees. The sun was out, but I couldn't upload. Oh, and by the way, Tesla stock is up. Car sales down. They're LA, like everything shut down, all their factories. But dang it, you guys just keep pouring into TSLA. Somehow we got to squeeze these guys. We got to squeeze the T into the FANG stock. Facebook, Apple, Amazon, Netscape, and Google. If I made you laugh, remember, got to click the like. Where are we going to put the T? Are we going to call it the fat? Or let's just shove a vowel in there. We'll put an I in there. So it'll be like fatting. Oh, and trivia question for you. Can you go 1 year without eating? Some people are like, I just want to lose weight from this. Been eating too many double stoofs. Can you help me? Can you help me, Johnny Bravo? I'm like, yeah, stop eating. Oh, don't want to do that because then I'll die. True or false, a dude did not eat for over a year and lived. All he did was drink agua fria, and I think maybe he took vitamins. And no, I'm not a medical doctor, and I'm not telling you to starve yourself to death. Do your own due diligence. And then I want to take you guys over to this blog post. Really interesting article. You may want to read once in a while. Rather than watch maybe, you know, Main Street News, like get into people's heads and figure out, hey, what are you doing? How are you making money? What's going on? But I want to show you, with your knowledge, if you have knowledge, you can make money from that. You don't have to. You can have a job. I have a job. High school business teacher. I enjoy doing that. Do I make more money in the business world? Oh, 10 times more. Or whatever amount that I choose to make. I don't need a lot of money. I just need basic. But I guess if you live in Southern California, basic is a lot of money. I've always been with the mindset of just enough. I don't need to have a Lamborghini. I can rent one. I don't scam people because I have to sleep well at night. And I actually like people. Hence the reason why I could sell my course all day long and make as truckloads of money. But I sell three. Which to you, you're like, no, more. More is good. There's actually a really good quote, which I used in one of my videos that got demonetized. It was Wall Street, not Wolf of Wall Street. Nope, we have ethics here on this channel. We don't watch that dirty kind of stuff. But on Wall Street, he was asking him, like, how much is enough? And that's a good question to pose to you. How much? How much is enough? And his answer was more. Like any good narcissist, right? Always more, never enough. But this guy does correlations between 1929, 1987, 2000, 1973, 2008, and the consequential differences between all previous recessions and the current situation. And it's like one after another, households have never been so dependent on debt. Yep, real earnings adjusted for deep inflation have never, you spelt never wrong, that's okay. We'll give you the okay on that one, have been so stagnant from the bottom 90% for so long. Well, I'll tell you, the top 1%, the top 10%, not stagnant. We're all doing very well up here. And corporations have never been so dependent on debt. Yep, that's how they are who they are. The ones who win are the corporations, are the businesses. The ones who lose are the ones that get straight A's, go to college, and then go work for the corporations. And those guys are in ridiculous, you want to talk debt? The stock market has never been so dependent on what amounts to fraud, which, you know what, let me pause that for a second because I want to take you over to a professor that's all he does is study the Fed, also known as study the fraud. If things are so complicated, you know what that's called, kids? It's called fraud. But what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to take you over here to him, but then I'm going to forget to tell you how this guy actually makes money. So I'll just be real brief. So as you know, he writes articles maybe every day, and then he sells books and people buy his books. And I want you to think that way. Can you do something that you really enjoy? If you're on this channel and you're like, yeah, I love the Fed, I love fraud, like write on it. Give people the knowledge. I'm not a smart guy. I'm just a teacher that can articulate things, hopefully easy for you to digest, and then I offer solutions. But if you're like, I just don't have that marketing brain, I don't have that side of the brain. See, I don't have the smart brain. I have more of the marketing brain. I got the simple brain. Again, I teach high school, so I have to bring it down to a real low level. And these kids are like tsetse flies. They have the attention span probably less than a tsetse fly. And this guy right here, support him on Patreon. Whatever. And I'd never ask for you guys to ever support me. I would only give you a product that actually solves a problem in your life. And then you could make money. And that's what I do. I'm like, do you want this product? It'll solve a problem and it'll make you money. Would you like it? No? Okay. Fair enough. I grew up in a house full of Democrats and they liked handouts. They liked stuff like that. And I would rather work hard, work smart, work hard, pull myself up by the bootstraps that don't have any straps. That way I can remain in the same place. And not saying that being a Democrat is wrong or being a Republican is right or wrong, or like people are people. And I understand if you don't have the knowledge, yeah, I would want a handout. And then I also don't blame people for sitting at home if they're going to get $4,000 a month. But I'm also not going to go on the other side and spend all my time and energy trying to fix laws and going into politics and all of that kind of stuff, when in the end, I know what the solution is. Pull back the curtain, get around the backside, learn how they do this, and make money. I mean, if you want to change something, here's how you change something. Make a whole lot of money, and then use that money to change something. Do not use that said money on a bulletin board and stand on a street corner saying, impeach, you know, fill in the blank. Get off your boo-hole hole, make a shat ton of money, and then go change as many laws as you want. Ah, you see? That's mindset. But it's a lot easier to sit behind a computer and just complain all day, right? And you're like, comment section, like, how dare you talk about my king that way? Or my queen, whatever you guys want. I'm not here to debate or argue. It's like dang sports teams. And until you figure out that the sports team is a franchise, it's a business. People from, what, Las Vegas are getting the Raiders. Now Oakland's like, what do we do now? We don't got a team. That's correct. Why were you investing who you are in something that isn't even yours? It's a dude that made a lot of money that purchased a franchise. It's his. It's not yours. And now that business is now going to be in Las Vegas. Until we get him in Los Angeles because, hey, we just... How do we go from never having a team to having all of them? You guys must really like the smog. Boy, I just went ADD on you. I apologize. But what I want you to do is just listen to this professor for 10 seconds. The solution to the 15-year book.
I had excellent full-time research assistants in Washington who really, without that support, it never would have been finished. So it took 15 years.
Wow.
15 years. I did other things during that period, sometimes quite actively, like running a congressional commission.
So the book, The History of the Federal Reserve, that covers the Federal Reserve from its founding through 1986. What can you tell us about that history that would be of interest to the general public?
We think of the Federal Reserve as being the agency that provides stable growth and low inflation. In fact, there have only been two periods in its history when it did that. I mean, most of their history is a period in which they produced the Great Depression, the Great Inflation, a large number of business cycles. They contributed to the current crisis. Their judgments are not very good.
So basically, to summarize, this very important interview got 6 likes. It now just got 7. But to answer 15 years, age-old question, of a book of what's, you know, the Fed's responsibility, pretty much nothing, and they're going to screw everything up. And this cat had teams working on this book for 15 years. And I guess we could sit here all day long and argue the Fed. I remember I had someone come into my classroom and they were arguing with me. One of the parents, big Fed supporter. I'm just like, okay, let me take a picture because this has never happened. And my recommendation is just know the truth. You know, just get enough to know. And then go make some money so you can live the life you want. You want to golf? Go golf. You want to surf? Surf. You want to go fishing? If that's what you're passionate about, then do fishing. Money is just a means to that stuff that you like to do. And if it's money that you need to do that, well, then get that so you can go fishing. But do you want to spend 15 years of your life, 20 years of your life debating and arguing about the Fed? Or would you like to be a little bit more productive? And all you have to do is provide a solution, a better solution, a better mousetrap. It could be digitally. It could be physically. Let me show you. I actually cannot believe that I am showing you this. But hey, you know what? Dirty laundry. Let's just put it all out there. This was something that I learned. I got a cold probably last year. And I was all congested and I couldn't breathe. And the doctor... See, this is knowledge, said, yeah, there's this thing called a neti pot. And I looked it up and I'm like, that looks horrible. And I tried it and I'm like, oh my gosh, I can breathe. I always thought I had a deviated septum. I couldn't breathe. And so what it does is it puts water through one side and then it comes out the other. You should probably Google it or you'd probably find a good meme on it. And I found one and I am totally dying. If you do not laugh, there is something wrong. There's something absolutely wrong with you. Tell me this channel does not hit all-time lows. But my point was that thing wasn't working for me, but I could breathe. It was like salt water. I'm like, oh my gosh, I can actually breathe. And that's when I found someone who made a better mousetrap, which is something like this, where it puts water in one and sucks it out and ends up being in the bottom. Sorry that I'm even mentioning it. But I have also more solutions to it, which a solution is you put something in the top, which is salt water. And so then the salt water, and they sell you, I'll show you. You can buy these things, these little packets. And they go in there, and the machine actually doesn't work unless you have one of these salt water packets in there, which you need. But I'm 100% sure those salt water things are patented, but they're making money on that because I have to order those because the machine doesn't work unless I hack it. But then I came out with, if I put a drop of peppermint oil in there, I can breathe even better. And then from there, I could actually make little pods, or I can make, you know, something that would go into, you know, a neti pot or something like that, and it dissolves. I mean, this is just how my mind thinks. I go down rabbit holes and go, okay, and then I sell it on Amazon and I make $10,000 a month, which pays for my fishing or my surfing or whatever I do. And all I have to do on my phone is click a button when I run out of inventory. But it's not just that. Like, I've done straws, or like something like this, where it's a straw. You know, in California, you can't have straws. And this is, you know, it folds up, and this does not fold up. I probably could fold it, but you can pull it apart. Or that's a problem. Like, oh, it's too hard. It doesn't, you know, look at that. It's like an accordion, but it's a better mousetrap. And so then this person makes $10,000, $100,000 a month. Or even something as stupid as this. This tripped me out. My wife's like, will you do me a favor and order me a round brush? I think this thing was like $50, but because they use a specific wood, everyone buys this. And how many dudes out there? That's why I have a course on this, link in the description. I only offer three codes though. It's for $197. It's a $1,300, two courses for $197, and the codes go super darn fast. But I teach you about things like this, like, okay, there's only one dude that makes this. Well, then make this and make it better, or even make the same thing. If there's only one dude and this is not patented, it's like, even if it is patent, I'm not, whatever, long, it's in the course. But no competition. Like, this guy's hand over fist, cash, being able to go fishing. It's not about the money. It's what you can do with your life. And also, like, my daughter, she flies for American Airlines. That's your time. Most valuable resource that you have is time. If you had 5 minutes left, you had all the money in the world, would you then trade that all the money in the world for more time? Yes, you would. That's why time is the most valuable asset that you have. And our government steals that from you, because you go get a job and they steal your most valuable asset so they can, you know, live the lifestyles, which I'm pretty sure it's sucky poo poo. So don't try to be like them. Just do what you like to do. Go fishing. Or like my daughter flies for American because she likes to travel. So she likes her job, but she's going to make more money. She has a YouTube channel too. You could look it up. I think it's Jordan Stenzel, or Vanica. I don't know how she changed it, but she's going to make more money selling a course or a booklet on how to become a flight attendant. It's very difficult. I think it's easier to get into Harvard than it is to become a flight attendant for something like American. Percentages, how many people apply, whatnot. Very, very difficult. And people will pay her for the knowledge. Will people pay you for your knowledge? What do you have that can solve a pain point that someone could pay you for? I mean, could people, or would people, want to buy your quick start guide on how to trade Bitcoin? Oh, bull flag failed. We looked at that. I could have showed that's, you know, clear bull flag done and failed. So that, does that mean that we're going from 7,500 to 6,500? Well, I will buy your knowledge if it could make me money in the future. And that's how my buddy Charlie, he makes sure Lambo money selling his course. I'll leave a link in the description, 10% off on how to trade equities. Very important skill to have. I'd say it's probably one of my top five. Learn how to start a business and learn how to invest said money. Yes, I could have crushed it making a trading course, but I would have lost my life. And I don't ever want to point you guys in the wrong direction. Financial advice, super dangerous. And you have YouTubers that are out there. They're like, oh, I'm all in with GoPro. Couldn't imagine that. I'm all in at GoPro at $63. Now it's at $2. I can't live at night, or could not live at night, giving you guys advice on something that I am not 100% sure. And that's why I'm like, I do know how to trade. I trade very well, and I trade with probabilities. And if it's an 80 cent probable chance that it's going to go up, yes, I'm going to make that bet. There's always the 20%. And that's why I put in a stop loss, because I would be okay with losing $2,000. I'm actually not okay with losing anything. $2,000, $500,000, Is there an amount that you're like a dollar? Ah, okay, I'll do a dollar. But okay, let's say I lost 2K. Well, that definitely is a lot better than losing 100K. That's not 100, that's 10. 100K all the way to $2. And then telling everyone, oh, we're just going to hodl someday. And I do think 80%, you guys could probably just with one course, if you can get 80%, you are golden. You don't need to spend 15 years learning about the Fed to know the whole game is fraud. Money is fraud. Well, money is gold. What they're able to do with that said money or digits and fractional reserve banking and pixie dust, that's a whole different story. But I did a video. You can go back. I showed you how to trade Tesla just by understanding the RSI and the MACD. You don't even need to know bear flag, bull pennant. Now, I have to say, this is not financial advice, but it would go something like this. On the MACD, you buy here, you sell there. 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 You buy here, you sell anywhere over here, and you buy here, and you sell there. Just on understanding the RSI, Relative Strength Index, when things are overbought, oversold. Now, I'm not going to add all these up, but I'm going to guess that you will 100% double your money. But remember, never listen to me. Otherwise, you will lose 1,100%. This cannot be financial advice. I'm not going to be holding the bags for you on GoPro and going like, oh, just keep holding. And yes, you're going to lose at a lot of trades. And that's the way it is. And traders, new traders, just they lose and they're like, oh, I'm all out. I can't stomach losing money. But I honestly can say probably a week's of learning just the basic fundamentals in trades will be a life changer. Like even looking at this formation right here, I get a little nervous. Here, I'll zoom in for you so you can kind of see what I'm looking at. Do you see what I see? These are just common trading skills that you'll just pick up along the way and you're like, I don't know, man, I just saw a green lightsaber. Well then, good. You take that $1,200 and you go put it down on a brand new car. Because as we know, brand new cars have one of the best investment vehicles ever to lose all of your everything. But also, after this is all said and done, I'm gonna give you just, in my brain, towards the end of the video, the basic ways, depending on your brain, what do you got? Do you got a lot of knowledge? No, you can work with your hands, okay. My recommendation is you probably should start here and work your way up to there. And also for me, like trading equities all day, sitting at a computer, just making trades would drive me crazy. But Johnny Bravo, I came here because I want to hear about how horrible people are so we can come together of how horrible lazy Americans are. Millions of Americans are now making far more money. Read this, far more money being unemployed than they did when they were actually working. And here you go. Here she is sitting there drinking her Job with her socks, and you wanna know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna complain about it. No, I'm not. I'm going to sell this Job drinker a pair of socks. I mean, one way is I can drop ship it to her because she's on Facebook all day long. And I'm like, boy, don't you wish you had a duck sock or a cat sock or a sock on the bottom that says, bring the stimulus or I make more money not working? I mean, think about it. And all I have to do is find out what her interest is on Facebook. And it cost me, what, $1 for a sock? And I charge her $20 and she just clicks. And I send this to her and I make $20. That's called drop shipping. Every time a sale comes in, I run over here, like this 1,101 orders. And AliExpress, a lot of times, is out of the United States. So these kind of things get there in just a few days because people don't like waiting. Or you can come over here and make your own neti pot. Don't even ask me. Or a different one that's better for a dollar and you sell it for $30. But I would use Alibaba. These are where Chinese manufacturers meet with you. It's kind of like eBay. eBay doesn't sell anything. They're just connecting a buyer and a seller. And then you're like, you know, you can negotiate the price. 70 cents? Nah, I'll pay 50 cents. But in the end, those are the kind of like negotiating skills that you would get in a course that you have the knowledge that you can then apply and you can make money and you can stop waiting for government handouts. But you guys like bad news, so here we go. U.S. auto sales show signs of life. That's actually some kind of good news, but if you read into the article, it just doesn't look good. For the week ending April 19th, retail sales were down almost 50%. But the good news is we had a 3% uptick in car sales because they're offering loans of you just don't ever have to pay us back. And you could get a brand new car. And here's another article. Car sales fall to a 10-year low. April 11th, pretty recent. And more about the fake stock market. This shows you China in particular suffered a sharp fall in electric and hybrid electric vehicles. Really? You wouldn't notice that by looking at Tesla stock, now would you? See, there's a big difference between the financial economy and the real economy. Disneyland could probably never open up again, and they'd probably still vault higher. And I did say I would touch on home sales, and I keep picking Las Vegas, because Las Vegas is highly susceptible to upswings and downstreams, no streams, market trend and statistics in Las Vegas. Let me get this out of my hair. I like to say the trend is your friend until the end. So here we are, active inventory. Oh, since a year ago, we're down 21%. Let's take a look at condos. So a year ago, a regular condo would be 170. I'm sorry, a year ago, a condo would be 180,000, but now it is 170,000. That is minus $10,000 just in 12 months. Do I think this trend will continue? Probability? That's what I focus on. 80% chance, probability that home sales will decline. And total inventory since a year ago, we are down 27%. And is it just me, or does $10,000 seem a lot worse than 5%? And then last but not least, again, there is a million different ways to make a million different dollars. I can either A, which I actually do, one of my courses is arbitrage. That was the first one. It's so simple. You're just buying something on Amazon and reselling it on Amazon. And this guy was making, and I saw Brian's numbers, it was about $10,000 a month. I'm like, holy crud, because he was buying my product that was a private label that I would actually make. And I'm like, hey, how'd you buy it and sell it for cheaper than, and he's like, well, I got a coupon from you. And I'm like, oh, and so I created a course on it. And then my second one was actually how to create a product. But these kind of knowledge information is so critical. Maybe not so much content creation. It depends on what you want to do with your life. Do you want to learn how to create content? No. You want to work with your hands. You just want to do online arbitrage. And I would say that this is probably one of my favorite ways for people that are just, you know, just want to fish. And I'll buy things online and I'll resell it online. I don't need to have a whole lot of knowledge in anything. And for me, this is called an affiliate. So I don't have to spend a whole year, which I actually did. I just didn't finish filming it. And I'm like, ah, you can have it, Brian. Because Brian knows what this is, what his whole channel is about. Go follow him, Online Arbitrage. And I think he gives you guys a few $100 off of his course. I did have to beg, but I know this stuff works because I've done it. I've done Amazon for over a decade. I couldn't believe online arbitrage, how easy it was. People are actually shocked that I even did a course on it. They're like, wait, you're just buying it from Amazon and reselling it. Why do you have a course on it? Why did it take you 20, 30, 40 videos? But it's things like this, like great. This is how easy it is. It costs you $3 and you probably sell for $7, whatever. Don't look at that. I was just looking at that because I use that, you know, the oils like this, right? I'm like, shoot, I could have got this for, also it's a good way for you to buy things really cheap. Peppermint oil. Ah, I'd like to shove that up my nose. But looking at the next one, you pay $7 for it and you sell it for $18 on eBay. If you know what you're doing on Amazon and you're running like IP alert, things to tell you that they're not mean people that'll go, oh, it's a fraud. But again, that comes with knowledge. Or you're over here buying some good old lion's mane for $0. It looks like it's selling on Amazon for about $23. But it's things like that, that just like, oh, okay, if I can make $10 a day, which is pretty easy. That's $300 a month. That pays for my car payment. Or you could think, okay, that'll pay for the course or whatever, or I'll do two a day and that's $600. Or if you have a lot of knowledge, well, then you may take a different route. This is just what I teach high school kids, the basic level, so they can make an extra, back in the day was $10,000. I can't guarantee that anymore. That's not so much. Private label, possibility if you can launch a good product. But this is just your basic way on how to flip something online that actually works. And I will see you tomorrow.